السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه أما بعد. Beloved brothers and sisters, mashallah, tabarakallah, here we are in Toronto, Canada, alhamdulillah. As you see the snow around us, mashallah, tabarakallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the 17th juz in Surah Al-Hajj, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍّ عَمِيقًا. This is an instruction to the great Prophet of Allah, Ibrahim عليه السلام. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructs him, O Ibrahim, أَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ. O Ibrahim, call the people for Hajj. Tell them that Allah has made the pilgrimage, the Hajj, farz upon them. And subhanAllah, the ulama have written that the legacy of Hajj actually goes back to Adam alayhi salam. But Hajj as we know it, subhanAllah, was initiated like this by Ibrahim alayhi salam, the instruction by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah has written in his tafsir under this particular verse, as well as Ibn Kathir rahimahullah in his tafsir. They write that Ibrahim alayhi salam then climbed Jabal Abi Qubais, which was a small mountain in Mecca. Now Makkah, mashallah, tabarakallah, we see the infrastructure. But then Makkah, subhanallah, was just a desert with mountains. Subhanallah. So Ibrahim alayhi salam climbed the mountain Jabal Abi Qubais, and he made the call. O people, ayyuhan nas, inna Allah qad farada alaykum al-hajja fahujju. O people, Allah has made farz upon you the pilgrimage of the house of Allah, Hajj. So perform the Hajj. Subhanallah. And Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah actually mentions a beautiful tradition, subhanAllah, in this particular regard, that Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he was instructed by Allah to make the call for Hajj, he said, Oh Allah, sawti da'if, Ya Allah, my voice is weak. How will the people hear my call? You know, that wasn't a time of social media, right? It wasn't the time for mass communication. There's no hashtag, things won't be trending. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Ibrahim alayhi salam, and what a beautiful lesson it is for us. He told Ibrahim alayhi salam, Oh Ibrahim, alayka nida' wa alayya al-balagh. Ibrahim, your job is to make the call. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let your call be heard. And it's a beautiful lesson for us, my brothers and sisters, that when we make any effort fi sabilillah, for the sake of Allah, with a sincere intention, we do it for the sake of Allah, and insha'Allah, we leave the results in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, masha'Allah, tabarakallah, we know the importance of Hajj, the beauty of Hajj. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a beautiful hadith that mashallah, most of you brothers and sisters probably know, we sing it in anashi to our children, Buniya al-Islamu ala khamsin, shahadati an la ilaha illallah wa Muhammad Rasulullah. It's a long hadith. At the end, wa hajjil bayti man istata'a ilayhi sabila. Right? To perform Hajj, Hajj is farz upon a person who has the financial and the physical ability to do so. And the beauty of an accepted Hajj, subhanAllah, the hadith of Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim and Sunan al-Tirmidhi. One of the hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu said, سمعت Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يقول, I heard Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, من حج فلم يرفث ولم يفسق رجع كيوم ولدته أمه. Allahu Akbar. Whomsoever performs the pilgrimage, the Hajj, and does not commit any act of obscenity, doesn't commit any evil act, that person will return from Hajj like the day, subhanAllah, their mother gave birth to them. Allahu Akbar. Free from sins, cleansed from sins. In the hadith of Sunan al-Tirmidhi, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the beauty of al-Hajj al-Mabrur, an accepted Hajj, a blessed Hajj, a beautiful Hajj, an accepted Hajj, laysa lahu jaza' illa al-Jannah. There is no reward for such a Hajj except for Jannah. MashaAllah, tabarakallah. So brothers and sisters, here we are, alhamdulillah, in this beautiful month of February. But inshallah, when we will perform Hajj, it'll be much more warmer than this, bi'ithnillahi ta'ala. So we invite you with Labayk Hajj, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. We invite you to Hajj 2020, mashaAllah, tabarakallah. This year we will be performing Hajj with Labayk Hajj, mashaAllah, tabarakallah. We have so many different scholars and mashayikh from all over Canada who will be joining us, so many brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah. So we send you and we give you this beautiful invitation, inshallah. Come and perform Hajj with us. Let us embark on this beautiful journey of Hajj. There are so many different options and packages for you to choose from, but let us go on this journey. We pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make easy for us this beautiful journey of Hajj. We pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of us, inshallah, if not this year. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us and open doors for us. There are people who want to go, but they cannot go. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open doors for all of us to time and again perform Hajj and perform Umrah. And for those who are blessed to go, inshallah ta'ala, with us or anyone else, for Hajj this year, inshallah ta'ala, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it that we go and we return, as the hadith says, كَيَوْمٍ وَلَدَتْهُ أُمُّهُ. We return as the day our mothers gave birth to us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, all our brothers and sisters. And inshallah, we look forward to seeing you on this Hajj together, this coming Hajj season, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Jazakumullah khayran for your time and for listening. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.